Hi guys, this is Zero Mella MD. I'm a physician, I'm a firefighter, I'm a writer. And today, since I'm trying to bring back some of the old videos, it will be vlog 11, and this is the rabies educational video. You can see in this video that some actual patients who have rabies were videotaped 1998 by the resident doctors of San Lazaro Hospital. So some of the videos will be cut out or edited out because of their violence. The title of this video, original title, is Walang Pinapatawad ang Rabies, which means that rabies is merciless. Or yeah. So it shows the last few moments or last few days of some of the patients that were diagnosed. Here we are shown the actual number of people that died in each of the major cities that during 1998. It's the reason why this video was made. A lot of those traditional healers, as shown here, treat dog bites as if they were snake bites. So they do some things that could lead to the death of patients. So this is why this video was made way back. So and it was done hastily. So as you can see, the animation was not even at par during that time. But it was good enough that a lot of people were able to understand it, since it's in the vernacular language or Filipino. So virus, way back then, a lot of people have a lot of Filipinos have very limited information about viruses. So this virus, as explained in here, can enter the central nervous system through the neurons and can proliferate in them, wherein the proliferation can lead to the virus being transmitted to the brain. The first signs are actually inflammation or tingling in the sense in the area of the bite. That's why a lot of traditional healers think that it's like a venom, and they suck it out the saliva of the dog. They try to suck it out from the dog bite. That's why they get the rabies disease themselves. So it's shown here that the virus travels very slowly. It's actually traveling at a rate of a few millimeters per day. It travels slowly to the brain. That's why the symptoms can appear from 1 month from the bite to a year from the bite. And then the symptoms are usually worse when it's already affected the brain. Once it affects the brain, the rabies virus is very lethal. So the first signs, as you can see, tingling or sensation in the dog bite area. You can have B symptoms, you can have cough, colds, and fever, or chills. And then, lungkot or pagkabalisa is Tagalog for depression. So, as you can see, this thing also happens in animals. They isolate themselves from other animals. In humans, this is manifested as depression or social isolation. So here they are showing that the patient is being given the vaccines and anti-serums. So however, to show that it's ineffective, they give a cup of water to show that this patient is actually experiencing already hydrophobia. Some patients experience aerophobia. The very act of swallowing is painful to them, but they need the water. As you can see, yeah, there is no intravenous fluids. There is no IV fluids given to these patients. They are not sedated, and they feel every sensation is felt. by the patients. The relatives are always nearby so they can talk to the patients, but most patients are combative. They are very angry. If you can understand Filipino, I'm sorry, but I can't dub this video. I can only make a reaction video on it and explain to you what is happening. So here's a child that died from rabies. He manifested increased strength, and you can see that in here. This guy is actually cursing the nurses. They're cursing everybody because he was told that he was going to die from this disease. So some people take it well. Relatives are actually allowed to go and try to feed the patients because eventually they'll try to eat, but the very act of eating is painful. Okay, so you can see that that this kid is trying as much as possible to eat, but he can only eat a few bites or a few sips at a time. That's why there's a straw. So as you can see, yeah, the pain, they can't actually swallow their own saliva. So they are trying. They feel some paresthesias as they have altered sensorium, and as you can see, she's spitting out the saliva. Eventually, she can't breathe. As you can see here, she can't breathe, and the relatives are trying to just wipe out the saliva. And here, he tries to eat, but she really can't. Okay, so she tries to swallow, but then spits out the food. And then here is when the nurses come to give him some sort of medication. Hopefully, I know this is sedation. However, as you can see in the videos, that sedation sometimes doesn't work. Here's the kid again. He's trying to get out. He's very combative and he shows increased strength. He actually broke the glass windows right here. Yeah, just trying to escape. Unfortunately, the San Lazaro Hospital is a very large compound, which is very heavy. There is a lot of staff members that will always bring them back. So these are the last moments of the patients, and I will be cutting here because it's very violent. So it shows the death of two of the patients. Until usually the patients are paralyzed and they can't breathe. That's how they die. And here is the relative, one of the relatives, and she can't take it. The patient has been there for a very long time. There is no medicine. Even the vaccines won't work once the symptoms appear. So this is a public health video, so it shows that the transmission is through saliva. So the act of kissing and the act of having a dog lick you, and also eating meat and brains of dogs. There are parts of the Philippines that still eat dog meat. So because of this video, a lot of Filipinos have already stopped eating dog meat, but there are still others who still do it, especially in the provinces. So just wash. You don't need to put anything else. A lot of Filipinos, I've seen a place toothpaste. You can just use iodine after washing the wound. And then just when you are bitten by a dog or any animal, you just need to go to an animal bite center, which is now available everywhere in the Philippines. Just you need to ask the municipal health office where it is located, and also the local government hospitals. So we usually give vaccines. Day 0, day 3, day 7, day 14, day 28. So that's the schedule. So the dogs are observed. The biting animal is observed. It's usually a dog. So bats can bite too. Bats don't actually exhibit the symptoms of rabies, but dogs do. So pets, pet dogs, you can see weakness, you can see aggression, you can see depression, and you can see that the saliva is drooping. They are numb to pain. They are very, very strong, and they are very easily agitated. Okay, so a lot of people sees the rabies eyes, the rabid eye. So they just look straight at you. They actually don't turn. They don't turn their eyes to the left or right. They just look straight. Sometimes the dogs will just walk straight. So the dogs walking straight with a drooping saliva, that's characteristic of rabies. So the following instructions are what we did. This was 20 years ago. I was still just high school then. We were told that if you were bitten by an animal, you have to sever the head of that animal. Okay, these were the Department of Health's instructions. Actually, it's still one of the procedures today, but it's optional. But then, during the outbreak of rabies during the 1998, they were instructing people to do that. So it's very cruel. Yes, I know. You can comment down below that it's very cruel. But this is something we did 20 years ago, and we sent the heads, the severed heads of the animals, on this addresses, wherever the nearest address of the nearest laboratory is. So this is a public health video that was created using limited resources, and they had to do it very fast. So you can see animations are just crude, okay, compared to what we can do today. You can see that they tried to explain rabies through history, how the dogs are man's best friend, but then a certain doctor, a biologist, a French biologist by the name of Louis Pasteur, developed the very first vaccine, antivirus, because he observed it in an animal, in a dead animal, and he tried to save the very first boy that was saved from the rabies vaccine is in Wikipedia. You can find that out in Wikipedia. The vaccines, inoculation of vaccines were through scratches back then. But now we inject the vaccine. We inject the anti-serum too. So that's how we do it. We have been giving, the veterinary offices have been giving antiviral shots to pet dogs ever since the outbreak in 1998. So you can see here what is happening through the community as they surrender their own pets so that the rabies vaccine is given to the animals. This is actually free. So some of the medications are subsidized by the government, others they have to buy. But during that time, rabies was priority number one, just like COVID is today. Rabies was priority number one, and everybody was getting free shots of rabies vaccine. So it shows here that the people are instructed to surrender their pets for vaccination. Okay, so every time the city veterinary office visits the barangay, it's usually for teaching proper responsible ownership of pets. So one of them is giving them vaccine and neutering them. So to control the population of the dogs. So here, the barangay involvement. Barangays are small local government units. They are active in the process of health education. So, following instructions, as long as it's 3 months old, you can vaccinate it. So just give proper health and nutrition to the dogs. And always take care of your pets. Okay. So,
ang Bureau of Animal Industry ay handang-handang sumuporta sa inisiyatiba ng mga komunidad tungo sa pagpuksa ng rabies.
So, we can see the city veterinarian delivering the vaccines, some mild reactions from the animals. So, this was 20 years ago and it has proven effective because rabies cases today just number below 10 in the Philippines. Longo po, the last case was 2 years ago. It was just one case. So through this method, rabies was almost eradicated in the Philippines. So it was a big problem 20 years ago. So here it's shown you need to be responsible pet owners. So what do we do when, what's the first aid? Don't go to albularis or traditional healers because they make it worse. You need to go to the animal bite treatment center. I tell patients to go to emergency rooms. You don't want this to happen to you or your pets. Okay, so yeah, so Pinoy responsible owners of dogs. So that's the video. That's the video we have for today. Hopefully, I'm very sorry, but I can't play the audio without me speaking on it. I need to have original commentary. So YouTube wants me to comment on my video. So it'll be like this for the next 100 or so episodes. I'm very, very sorry. But if you like what you are hearing here, please click subscribe. And you'll have me explaining the videos and hopefully you learn something from it. And I think this is a good way for me to teach. You can still comment down below and ask any questions about this video. As always, if you like what you see here, click the thumbs up sign. And if you're not subscribed, click the subscribe and ring the bell for notifications. Thank you very much for watching. I'm Zero Mella MD and peace out.